Issues you might be having with some of your shoes. It's a shoe stretcher, man. It's a two-way shoe stretcher. I think the name of the company is Foot Fitter, and they come in a pair. I believe they were like maybe 40 bucks, 39, something like that. Maybe I think 45 bucks total with shipping and everything. And it comes with one stretcher. Two stretchers. It's a pair of them. And they also come with this shoe stretch spray, which I haven't actually used this yet. But you know, I got some Sunday Best joints that, you know, when you break them joints out, they, you know, they're a little stiff sometimes. You know, it takes a little while for them to warm up to your feet. So I guess you just spray this down on the inside of them. You know, put these bad boys in there, and they actually come with these little knob joints that you can actually, like, there's holes all around these joints. Like, you know, let's just say you got an old pair of kicks, or not necessarily old pair, maybe a new pair, that might be rubbing you, like, in one spot on your shoe. You just kind of guesstimate where that spot's rubbing at, and you take one of these little joints and stick it on here. It's like, they have different size ones. Like, this is the big one. This is the medium size one, and this is the small one. And there's a pair for each shoe. You know, there's a set for each shoe. And I remember when I first bought the first pair of phones I had with the hologram joints. And since I knew that they was notoriously snug, you know, tight fitting, so I went ahead and bought these beforehand and just stuck them down in the shoe. And, you know, before I knew I was gonna actually wear the shoe, they say, I think they recommend you do it like maybe 8 hours before you're gonna wear the shoe. So if you know you're gonna wear the shoe the next day, you know, maybe just stick them in there the night before or something like that. You know, just at least until the shoe gets broken in or anything. Like these foams, I ain't never had these on, these Wu-Tang joints. I never had them on. But I'm just gonna show you how easy it is to stick this joint down in here. I'm not gonna put the pegs on, I'm just, you know, showing this one. Just showing you how to actually put the thing in here. Just push it down and pull that. Grab the pull tab joint and actually do I have this locked all the way down on there? First, you should make sure it's as compact as it can be, because I think I actually have this one's actually a little open. And they actually stretch your shoe lengthwise if you need, or they actually stretch your foot side to side, like in the toe box area, you know, if you need that. I mean, it's just a good investment to have. And, you know, they don't warp your shoes. And I'm telling you right now, my foams, my the pink ones, when before I wore those, I had this thing, like, stretched out to, like, it goes out pretty far. It goes out pretty far. So I had this thing, like, maxed out. And I even had the knobs on it just to make sure I had as much area in there as possible. And, like I said, they don't want the shoes. You know, these, you know, phones are tough. They're like tanks. You know, I mean, you could even do it with some J's if you need it, you know, to give you some extra play and everything. And you just push it down in here. Joints in there, and you just take it and you twist this way, and it actually spreads the front part of the shoe out. I've stand corrected. This actually lengthens. This actually spreads the front part of the shoe out. I'm going to try and spread this out a little bit so you guys can see the difference in the actual shoe, what it actually makes the shoe look like. I'm going to hold one up next to the other one so you guys can tell the difference. But, you know, it's just something that, you know, a lot of sneakerheads may need, may not, you know. Everybody's foot's not the same. But, you know, sometimes, you know, if you want to buy, let's say you wear a size 10 and a half and you found a shoe that you always wanted and you couldn't find it in but a 10. So you could go ahead and get the 10 possibly, you know, if it was close. And then you could stretch it with this shoe stretcher and you'd probably be good to go. See, look how that's already stretched. Let's do a comparison with the other one. So you can see the difference in how the shoe has been stretched. And trust me, you know, phones are tanks. And I've even stretched some of my J's. I did the Jordan 11 lows before I wore those, stretched those. I did the Jordan 5 lows, stretched those. I did some, like I said, I did some threes, stretched those. And like I say, man, you just leave it in there for, you know, overnight or whatever. And you come back the next morning and, you know, put the shoe on and good to go. But, you know, it's just a little something that, you know, sneakerheads might find useful. I'm also looking for a hat stretcher. Because like I said, some of those places, man, seven and a quarter at one place might not be a seven and a quarter at another place. And, you know, your hat might be a little snug. You know, I've heard the thing, you know, put the hat on your knee and pull it and all that. Well, I ain't trying to bust the seams open, nothing like that. So if you have a hat stretcher, you know, you can do your stretching gradually. So I wanted to take this one all the way back out and then show you how this foam has already come back to size. I'm afraid I don't leave it in that long, but look, still back to the same size. So that's that. Like I said, this spray, you know, that's for like probably more leather, like, you know, like church type shoes, something like that. It'd be a little hard to get one of these joints down in the boot. I mean, it's a little tough getting it down in the foam posit because the foam posit comes up so high in the back. But other than that, you know, they pretty much usable probably any shoe you got. You know, so that's just a little quick tutorial on the shoe stretcher. Like I said, I think the name of the company is Foot Fitter. And it's called a two-way stretcher. Like I said, they were about $40. I looked them up online and went and copped them and, you know, been using them ever since. Now, I will tell you, these little things, they kind of fall out. So when you put them in the shoe, once you put it in the shoe, the pressure of you expanding the shoe makes it kind of stay there. But when you go to take them back out, they kind of fall out. They're like, you know, they're not super snug on these little holes or nothing like that. And I don't suggest you gluing it on there because you're going to be able to move it around. So, you know, well, that's that, fellas. And if you guys have any suggestions of some other videos or anything you want me to do, you know, just drop it in the comments below. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed, hit that subscribe button. You know, I don't care about the thumbs up on the video, thumbs down, but that'll do nothing for me. But yeah, just keep subscribing, man. Let me know you like what I'm doing, and keep rocking with your boy Wood, 804, King of Phones and J's, and I'm out.